Hi, we are Project Scorpio. We are part of the Off-Road Student Association at the Wrocław University of Science and Technology. We have been operating since 2011. We come from different universities and consist of 5 different departments: mechanics, electronics, software, marketing, and science, all in all having over 40 members. We are one of the oldest and most titled teams in Poland, and we use our knowledge to promote the space sector in our country. Our team has traveled all around the world taking part in multiple competitions and conferences. This year we've already competed in Australian Rover Challenge in Adelaide and will soon be departing for University Rover Challenge. Last year, we have been a part of the first edition of Anatolian Rover Challenge and got to be first ever winners. In order to organize and store our project, we use software such as Discord for communication, Eagle for electronics design, SolidWorks for mechanical design, GitHub for software cooperation, and ClickUp for task distribution. Physical work takes place at our small workshop in one of the dormitories. Here we assemble and program the rover. We have access to basic tools and materials. More sophisticated components are made by external contractors. We test our rover in an indoor and outdoor environment. Basic tests are performed at the workshop, but more complex ones, like range and autonomy tests, take place at a nearby parking lot or an abandoned airfield. To expedite our workflow, the board makes most of executive decisions, but the most important ones are being voted on by all the members. Our board consists of leaders from all 5 departments, as well as both team leaders and project manager. Leaders are responsible for their own departments, being backed up by their vice leaders, while team leaders work together in order to supervise and coordinate all departments and liaise with the university. Scorpio 7 has a dependent 4-wheel rocker suspension system. Rockers are connected by 2 triangular levers linked by a beam. This solution increases the stiffness and stability of the whole system. Thanks to that, it can cross extreme terrains, such as obstacles up to the diameter of the wheel about 30 cm and vertical cliffs up to 1 meter. A very low center of mass allows us to overcome steep angles up to 45 degrees. The driving module features all-wheel drive with BLDC motors, which help the rover climb slopes in difficult terrain. Commands to motors of the mobility system are sent using the CAN bus. With our operator app, we can control each motor individually. To provide good traction on both the Mars and Moon field, we use special tires made of Cordura fabric. To comply with the rules, our rover fits in a cube with a side length of 1.2 meters. The whole suspension system weighs 36 kilograms. Our rover is powered by a 6S lithium polymer battery pack with a total capacity of 18,000 mAh, connected to other modules via a 24-volt bus. The drive module is equipped with a visible emergency stop button that cuts power to the battery in an emergency. Every PCB made by us has overvoltage, overcurrent, and reverse polarity protection. We use an NVIDIA Jetson AGX Orin as the main computer. We chose Jetson AGX Orin because of its ability to handle multiple video streams simultaneously and low power consumption. To connect each computer, camera, and other high-traffic modules, we use Ethernet connections. Other modules, such as the robotic arm, driving module, and scientific modules, use the CAN bus to provide robust communication. The robotic arm has 6 degrees of freedom and weighs 10 kilograms. We designed it with the use of a worm and harmonic gear reducers to maximize precision and stiffness. It has a maximum range of 1.2 meters and can lift up to 5 kilograms on maximal extension. Gripper moved by lead screw gives a satisfactory grip strength. We can change the end tips of the effector to adapt it to different tasks, such as taking soil samples. As main construction materials, we used carbon fiber, aluminum, and PETG to provide the necessary strength to mass ratio. Shoulder and elbow joints are powered by BLDC motors. Other joints use regular DC motors. To move and track the position of every joint, we use absolute encoders and custom controllers. It also allows us to incorporate 3D inverse kinematics. Inverse kinematics are controlled with the robot operating system MoveIt package alongside our custom written driver and planner. Some of the robotic arm positions are remembered as presets and can be easily navigated to. It's designed to simplify panel operation during sample and launch mission. Additionally, to help operators with precise manipulator, depth camera is installed that can measure the distance from the panel and display this information in our web application. To complete the first mission, our rover will be equipped with a science payload, the drill, which has a special design mounted on the rover, will extract samples that will be analyzed in the science module, which will be a universal terrain exploration platform called ULEP. This module is capable of storing up to 5 samples, which will be stored in sealed containers to limit contact with the environment and potential contamination of the samples. Our primary tools for analyzing the samples will be a microscope, which will help to identify the microfossil content and mineral composition of the samples, and a Raman spectrometer, which will provide spectral data crucial for examining the composition of the samples. The spectrometer will also help to detect organic compounds such as amino acids. All data obtained by the rover will be interpreted by our team at the science lab, where samples will additionally be chemically analyzed to confirm the hypothesis. Our communication system is based on 2.4 GHz AirMax technology, suitable for long-range applications. To maintain a strong signal with the rover, we created a rotor with a high-energy gain directional antenna. It is capable of autonomous tracking the rover in real time to provide the best signal possible. We are also focused on real-time bandwidth monitoring and data transfer optimization to create a much more stable communication system. The design system will ensure a strong and stable connection at Mars and Moon fields. The communication mast is modular and weighs 10 kilograms. Its height can range from 1 up to 3 meters. When extended over 2 meters, it is supported by a set of guy wires for stability. Recently, we put a lot of effort into autonomous navigation. We are able to avoid obstacles and navigate to GPS coordinates as well as to a point on our map. All autonomy modules are fully written by us, ensuring perfect integration with our onboard hardware and other software modules. We are also able to detect and drive to different landmarks such as AR tags. To control the rover, operators use our custom-made web application. It enables us to control every module of the rover, monitor system status, display cameras, and other data gathered by the rover. The rover's base modules, such as the drive unit and robotic arm, are designed to meet the requirements of all the rover challenges in which we participate. To adapt to a particular challenge, we work on the end effector of the manipulator to prepare for all tasks. Thanks to precise fingers, camera mounted on the gripper, and inverse kinematics, we are able for quick and reliable switchover. Also, we are designing a science module. For the Anatolian rover challenge, we are working on a sample probing system. Moreover, especially for the Karain mission, we are developing night searchlight. To ensure readiness of our entire team, we conduct operator trainings. Those include not only rover operation, such as driving and arm manipulation, but more importantly, setup training. We have incorporated trainings in our competition preparation in the past, and the results couldn't be better. We were able to ensure that every team member knows basics from every rover department, simultaneously going through rules of challenges multiple times and knowing it inside and out. Such deep understanding of the rules makes it possible to have amazing discussion about new ideas to improve current solutions.